Hello, this is Chaba, and today I'm going to show you how to create game-ready eyelashes for your character in under a few minutes. We are going to use our alpha texture that we exported from Unreal in our previous episode. I leave a link here if you skip that video. This step is essential in case you don't have an alpha texture already. With that said, it's going to be an easy tutorial, so let's get started. Okay, let's start with creating a new collection. Name it eyelashes. On the plane, scale it down and place it roughly to the lower eyelid, just like I'm doing here. Now create a rectangular shape, scale it on the Y and on the X if necessary. With Ctrl R, add two loop cuts. Go to side view and move the two edges upwards on the Z axis to make a slight bend. Smooth it and now place it close to the tear duct. Select your mesh. Go to edit mode. Now ideally we would want to select an edge that is flowing around the eyelids. But if you don't have a great topology, like I do here, that's not a problem. There is a few workarounds for that. But if you do have a great topo, like I had here, however, these workarounds are not considered even medicore. So let's see. Use edge select and with alt left click select one that is kinda matches that flow. Check it in material preview to see where exactly is our texture painted for the eyelids. Well, that's not really good. How about this? This is not good either. How about if I add an extra loop cut? If your character is rigged, then you even get a warning like I do here, but that sign doesn't stop me from doing it. Okay, let's add that loop cut, shift D to duplicate that edge, and with B, separate it. Hide that separated edge, then again select the same edge, press X and dissolve edges. And just like that, now we don't have that edge that would have caused errors. Now go back to object mode, unhide the separated edge and place it into our eyelash folder. And now convert this edge mesh to a curve. Now go to edit mode, select the upper part and with B, separate it. Now we have separate curves for the lower and the upper one. Now add the shrink wrap modifier to this curve, eyedrop on the character, and place the vertices just slightly inside on where the eyelids textures start. You should remove unnecessary vertices such as this. Lower eyelashes don't go all the way to the tear duct, so place the first vertices away from the tear ducts. Okay, seems good, let's do the upper one as well. Again, place them just barely at the start of the eyelid texture. This one can go almost all the way through to the tear duct. Now you can apply the shrink wrap modifier. Now really important steps, select the lower eyelash first, go to object and apply all transforms. Go to edit mode, select the first vertice here, then shift S. Cursor to select them. Then in object mode, set origin to 3D cursor. Do the same on the upper one as well. Now select the plane and place it and rotate it really close to the start of the lower eyelash. Then go to object mode and apply all transforms. Go to edit mode, select the edge that is facing the eyelid, shift S and cursor to select it. Object mode, origin to 3D cursor. Now duplicate the plane with Shift D and place and rotate it to the start of the upper eyelash like I am doing here. Once it's looking good, apply all transforms and with the same method like before, place our origin as well. Next, add an array modifier to the lower one and the curve modifier, eyedrop or select the lower curve. Now if you see this can happen because the edge is flowing in a different direction and Blender thinks that is the starting point. We can easily change that, with the curve selected, go to edit mode, segments, and switch direction. Now it should be all good. Now pump up that array. If it's still not aligned with the curve, go to edit mode and rotate the planes to align with the curve. Now let's just add more to fill it out evenly. Slightly rotate it if you see it's not perfect. And with G, move it just slightly inside till it's looking good. We can further tweak this if needed, select the far edge and with proportional editing push it downwards. Take away some array count if needed. We can make it a bit tighter while playing the offset. Okay, that's looking fairly good, let's do the upper one now. Again, array and curve modifier. And rotate it to align the curve. Select the last edge, use proportional editing and move it relatively far upwards with G. Make it more exaggerated in case of female characters. Okay, now open another window, set it to shader, add a material, you can unhide the curves, go to material eyelashes, drag another window, set it to UV editor, on an image texture, set the color to a really bright red value, you can turn on metallic, import an alpha texture from Unreal, set it to a non-color and plug it into the alpha. Now in the UV window, scale it down and look for a strand that fits for a lower eyelash. Look for a less dense, more loose looking one. I just turn off metallic for now. Okay, upper one, scale it down in the UV window and look for a dense one. In case of male characters, you not need to look for extremely dense one. Now let's just play with this a bit to make it more realistic. So in the UV window, you can even scale them on the Y or Z axis for a thicker result. Or you can scale up the plane in edit mode to make it more defined lashes. And modify the array accordingly. Now Shift D to duplicate this and with B separate it. Select the new separated one and look for a different variation of strands. Now make this one more dense, lower the offset rate and crank up the count number. You can play with the original one as well. And now just experiment with the different strands and density you want. You should also make a little bit of clamp effect with the duplicate selected in edit mode. Just rotate it very slightly. Again, just experiment with it, what looks best for you. Always check after modification that the cards are relatively still lying on the skin or not. Now for the upper one, let's make this far denser. Duplicate the mesh again and separate it with B. Make it, for example, less dense with a different hair strand. Again, make some clamp effect. And I would need to go far bigger here because of the density and visibility that I want. If it goes out of line, always place it back to the skin to align with the lid. These refinements are released depending on the look that you are going for, and it's going to have some trials and errors. Okay, let's name the meshes for organizing it a bit. Now let's see how we are with the triangle count. We are below the budget, so I can duplicate the upper eyelash one more. Again, different offset or count, then set a different hair strand. Now that's getting together as it seems. Let's see it in a more darker color. Name this one as well. Let's see. It's 246 triangle, seems fair enough. It depends on a lot of factors, but generally for a simple upper eyelash, you shouldn't go above 300. Okay, now let's apply the arrays. Now I can join them with Ctrl G. And if you don't want to move the whole eyelash, we can apply the curve modifier as well. Now let's make the lashes on the outer parts bigger. Duplicate some or modify some. Let's make the opposite on the inner parts, make them smaller. And now just add some randomness to a few cards, select different strands and move them a bit. You can even use proportional editing to make the scaling and placing easier. Keep checking your triangle count. Let's see the lower one. Apply the array and curve. And join them. Now let's modify this as well a bit. Remove full planes that is close to the tear duct because, as I said earlier, lower eyelashes doesn't go all the way to the tear duct. With proportional editing, you can just scale parts of the lashes with the mouse, so you can resize some additional clamp effect. Now let's get the inner planes a bit, because the closer they are at the beginning, the smaller they are. At this stage, add some, remove some, or modify the cards if needed. Let's scale the outer ones as well. Again, in normal case, these hair strands are much smaller compared to the middle ones. You can add some bigger ones to the middle part. Now let's see what we have. I turn back metallic now and select a darker color. Okay, it seems good to me. For last step, add the mirror modifier. Let's check the final triangle count as well. 276 for the upper and 150 for the lower one. That's fairly reasonable. So that's all for today. I hope you find it helpful. If you did, please leave a like, subscribe, and I will see you in the next one.